Hello guys, I hope all of you will be fine. So this is question 3.36 of chapter 3, and the statement of this question is: on a laboratory assignment, if the equipment is working, the density function of the observed outcome x is f of x, which is 2 1 minus x for the range of x greater than 0 and less than 1, and it is 0 otherwise. Okay, so what do we have to do on the basis of it? We have to answer certain parts of it. So let me look at the first part of this question, and this is calculation of the probability that x is less than or equal to 1/3. Okay, so by looking at it, I can very easily see that if I will find the CDF for my function here or for my density function here, I can very easily find out this thing. Okay, so let me first find the CDF for my function here, and in order to find the CDF of it, I know that what I have to do, this would be f of x, okay, that is capital F of x, and what I have to do, I have to take the lowest limit of my function and taking any arbitrary variable here and taking that arbitrary variable as x, because here this x should correspond with this one as well. Okay, so now taking it and now putting my function here by changing the domain of it. Okay, so let me change the domain of it from x to t. So what I will get here, it will be 2 1 minus t, and now integrating it with respect to t. Okay, so now doing this same procedure as well, so 2 will be outside and here we will have 0 x, okay, 1 minus t and dt. Okay, so now doing again 2, and here it will be 0 x 1 dt, okay, and also minus 0 x here t and dt. Okay, now integrating them separately and then putting the limits here, what I will get here, I will have here it will be t and 0 x, and while here I will have t square divided by 2 and 0 to x. Okay, putting these limits here, what I will get here, I will get 2, okay, and x minus 0 is x, similarly here minus 1/2, and here I will have x square minus 0 square, so here I will have x square. Okay, so ultimately I will get this one. Okay, so now moving somehow downwards, what I will get multiplying this 2 inside of it, what I will get, I will have here 2x minus x square. Okay, so this is what, this is the CDF of my function which I have here. Okay, so this is the CDF. In order to simplify it somehow more, what I can do here is that let me add and subtract 1 here. So adding and subtracting 1 here, what I will have, this is f of x, and here I will have minus x square plus 2x. Okay, and here let me subtract 1 and add 1 with it as well. Okay, so now here I will have this function. Now here I can very easily see that this is a function which is the factorization of x minus 1. If I will take this negative sign common here, so here I will have this minus, and here x square minus 2x plus 1. Okay, and here the remaining thing will be plus 1. Okay, so now combining it, and here I will get x minus 1 whole square, and here minus, and here plus 1, or the value of f of x is what? That is 1 minus x minus 1 whole square, and that is what? That is the CDF of my function as well. Okay, so you can use both of them. That is basically the simplified form, because in many books the answer has been written in this form. So in order to do them all is not to confuse them with anything, so that's why I have solved it as well. Okay, so now looking at part A of my question, I have to find the probability that x is less than or equal to 1 by 3, and that is very easily found out by putting f 1 by 3. Okay, so now putting the values here, this is f of x, so putting values here, 1 minus x value is 1 by 3 minus 1. Okay, so here it would be 1 minus, this would be minus 2 by 3 whole square, okay, or 1 minus 4 by 9, or the answer of it will be 5 by 9, and that is what, that is the answer of part A of my question. Okay, you have seen that how easy it is to find the probabilities if I know the CDF of my function. Now similarly, what is the probability that x will exceed 0.5? Okay, so that is the probability that x will be greater than 0.5, and this can be found out very easily if I will make it like probability that x is less than or equal to 0.5. Okay, so this is basically the CDF. I can find it out by using the CDF, which would be what, f of 0.5. okay, putting all the values here, this is f of x, so it will be 1 minus, here the value is 1 minus 0.5 minus 1 whole square. Okay, so here you can see that, let me move down somehow. Here you can see that by opening the braces, what I will get here, it will be plus 0.5 minus 1 is minus 0.5 whole square. Okay, these two will cancel out, and here the answer of it will be 0.25. okay, because the square of it will remove this minus sign, and that is basically 1 by 4. So the answer of part B is 1 by 4. Okay, so that is the solution of part B of my question. Now in order to solve part C of my question, here I can see that given that x is greater or equal to 0.5, what is the probability that x will be less than 0.5? Okay, so for it, let me move down again. Okay, so here, that is basically the conditional probability in which I have to find out the probability that x is less than 0.75 given that x is greater or equal to 0.5. okay, so that is what I have to find out. This is the conditional probability in which this thing has been given, and I have also find it out by using this function here, because previously I have already seen that what was this one, this was basically the probability that x is less than or equal to 0.5, and subtracting it from 1, I have got probability that x is greater than 0.5. so equivalent is also covered by this one, because this is the continuous probability function, and therefore this is the same thing. Okay, so now proceeding towards this one, what I can use here, I can use here the conditional probability, and here in order to do so, I will have these two function, and here I will have x is less than 0.75. okay, and the union of probability that x is greater or equal to 0.5, okay, and dividing it over what, here dividing it over the given probability, which is probability that x is greater or equal to 0.5. okay, so I hope this point is now clear. If you have put them together, and that is basically the union. So what is mean by union? Union means it has been combining these two ranges. Okay, so this range and this range, these two ranges has been combined, and therefore these ranges are from 0.5 to 0.75. so therefore in combining them, what I can write here, I can write here the probability that x is greater or equal to 0.5 and less than 0.75. okay, that is what, that is basically the limit or the limits of this probability and dividing it over the probability that x is greater or equal to 0.5. Okay, I know, I have already known the value of this one, so let me solve the other one as well. So now finding the limits here, I can very easily find this limit by using the CDF, and it would be what? It would be the f 0.75 minus f of 0.5, okay, and dividing it over the probability that x is greater or equal to 0.5. okay, so now here we can very easily see that these are the limits. And why did I do it? Because if I have a function here, okay, let me see that this is the CDF and this is if x, and in order to plot them here, what I can see, if I have here this one 0.5 and this one is 0.75, so in order to find this area here, what I can do, I can subtract this area from this one. Okay, so this is what, this is 0.75 and this is f of 0.5, so subtracting from this one, this I will get this area, okay, which let me identify in this blue color. Okay, so this blue color is basically showing me these ranges. Okay, so I hope you have found out my point. Okay, so now putting values here in the formula for f of x, what I had here, this is the formula which I had, so 1 minus x minus 1 whole square. So let me put these values here, and what I will get here, I will have 1 minus x minus 1, so 0.75 minus 1 whole square. Okay, so this is for this one, and now for the other one, I will have, this is minus, and I will have 1 minus 0.5 minus 1 whole square. Okay, so I will have this one, and dividing it over what, here I will have, this was already found out, and that is 1 by 4. Okay, so now let me solve them together. 1 minus 0.75 minus 1 is minus 0.25 whole square, and also here minus 1 and plus here 0.5 minus 1 is minus 0.5 whole square. Okay, and dividing it over 1 by 4. Okay, so these two will cancel out, and at the end I will have here this minus minus will be plus, this minus minus will be plus, 0.5 whole square minus 0.25 whole square divided by 1 by 4, and that is 0.25. okay, solving it out, what I will get here, ultimately I will get 0.75. okay, so which is basically 3 by 4. okay, so the answer of part C of my question is 3 by 4. But the only thing here you have to remember is this formula, that how we found out this formula, and that is due to the conventional formula of the conditional probability. Okay, so that's it for today, in which we have seen some important points related to the conditional probability and the usage of the CDF. If you have any question, you can ask me in the comment box. See you soon.